Today, I'm going to show you how I made this router table jig to make routing finger holds and cutting boards much, much easier and much safer. We do have the plans available for this on our website, so be sure to check those out in the description down below. Without further ado, let's get into it. It's time to get started making a jig for making cutting finger holds on the router table for cutting boards quite a bit easier. We do sell the plans for this on our website, so definitely check that out there. I started out by applying some ore mask to a piece of Baltic birch plywood. Then I picked up the 45624-K 60 degree Spektra coated V-bit with the Stepcraft M1000 CNC machine. We're going to use this to go through and make the ruler for this jig, and it's just going to go through that ore mask, making a really nice clean cut. And then we're going to be painting over the numbers to make the ruler a bit easier to see. Surprisingly, designing out this ruler is not particularly easy. It was definitely way more difficult to do than I ever thought it would be, but we did get that done. So I'm going to get that pulled off and painted using some General Finishes Lamp Black Milk Paint. And then we'll use the auto tool changer to pick up the 46176-K 8th inch compression bit. So I used a compression bit here for the entire design, but it's not meant for everything. This is a really shallow pocket that I'm doing here, and you can see that it tears out the ore mask quite a bit. That's because the upcut portion is the only portion touching the material. So I could have used a downcut bit here, but I wanted to show that a compression bit isn't necessarily great for everything. It's really great for through cuts, but you need to make sure that your first pass is below that upcut portion of the bit. So I used the compression bit basically to save time so that we weren't using another bit. And for this, it worked out perfectly, as there's going to be very minimal sanding. But you can see when we're going through here doing full depth cuts, it leaves a nice clean top and bottom surface that requires absolutely no sanding. So the amount of sanding, maybe 15-20 seconds of sanding I had to do on those star knobs, wasn't worth the time to change out the bit. If you love this type of content, be sure to subscribe to our channel and go ahead and hit that bell so that you'll be notified on all of the new videos when they're released. Also, don't forget to follow us on Instagram at ToolsToday. Holding it in place while I drive a screw in. So this is done. These will be the side supports. And now I did the exact same thing on the other side. And I'm just cutting a piece of walnut scrap down to size. And we're going to drill out a hole in the middle to accept a threaded insert. So this will allow me to have a little clamping pressure on the cutting board to keep it held nice and tight up against the fence. So we'll just insert in that threaded insert, and we can screw in a bolt to hold it in place. So you can see attaching it here, we'll do so on both sides. And we have a adjustable height here that will allow me to put that pressure on the cutting board. So then we'll get the T-nuts hammered into the star knobs, so that way we can get everything nice and secure from the backside. We'll use some quarter 20 bolts. The entire thing is made out of quarter 20 bolts. And then the star knobs will help secure everything here and will allow us to slide this back and forth using the ruler as our guide to get everything set correctly. Then I'll use some bolts and some T-slot nuts to slide into the fence on the router table. Worked out really well, and we can get that perfectly centered just using a V-bit to align everything perfectly centered with that zero mark on the actual jig. So now we can get everything bolted down now that we have it aligned correctly, and then we can adjust the fence back here on the backside to whatever measurement you want. This will set the length of the finger hold on the side of the cutting board, and it definitely makes it quite a bit safer here having a nice vertical stop like this and a nice big back support piece to make sure that your cutting board doesn't tip while sitting on the router table. So we can get the 45916 5/16 inch radius half inch shank core box bit set, and then I'll adjust the fence back so that we're in the exact middle of the cutting board. Then I'll adjust the bottom support piece to ensure that it stays nice and tight up against the fence, and we can slide it back and forth here. As you can see, we'll get the bit started. I'm going to take this in two passes to get down to the full depth, and we'll just move it back and forth using those fences as a stop. It works out perfectly having the nice tall fence, and then we can just move it back and forth to the opposite side. We contact that fence and then pull it up, and we're left with a really nice clean cut on there. So that's just one pass that we're going to be doing. We'll get it adjusted and raise the height of the router table and get the second pass done the exact same way. So this backstop here, having it really nice and tall, allows you to put pressure on the backside there while the bottom part keeps it held nice and snug. It works out really well, and you don't have any sort of deflection like you can have using a smaller fence. So I'm gonna raise the bit just a teeny tiny bit to do one final cleanup pass, as you can with cherry move a little bit too slow and cause some burning. We didn't have too much of that issue here, but I just wanted to do one final pass to clean everything up. And we're left with a perfectly clean finger hold on this cutting board, which is definitely something that's not typically easy to do without a setup like this on the router table. Be sure to check out those plans on our website. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. Have a great day, everybody. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you love this type of content, be sure to subscribe right over here. And for more great videos, click right over here.